What is going on, guys? My name is Alex. Welcome back to a brand new video. Now in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys exactly the best settings for OBS to use on Restream.io to stream on multiple platforms such as Facebook, YouTube, Twitch at the same time. So in the last video, I showed you guys like how to set up like the entire like interface and all the alert boxes and the layout and the stream, the whole thing. So in this video, I'm going to focus a little bit more specifically on the settings that you need, because of course you always want to choose what kind of resolution you're streaming on, you know, what kind of, you know, FPS and all that. So that's what we're gonna run through, of course, right after the intro. All right, guys. So as you can see right now, we are on Restream.io on our dashboard. And in this video, I'm going to focus specifically on getting OBS ready to stream with Restream.io. So if you haven't seen the last two videos, make sure to check out the playlist down in the description. But we basically came down to, you know, setting it up and going live into the live studio on Restream itself without any external software. So in the second episode, we also discussed how you get the best settings and how to get your stream key, how to, you know, set that all up and how to go live and, you know, change the titles. All the other things are in these videos, so if you haven't seen it yet, make sure to, you know, watch these first and then come back to this video. So right here, as you can see, it says live studio. Now if we're gonna enter the live studio, this will bring us to this menu where you can just use your webcam. For example, you want to click on allow, and right here, of course, you can see that we have our camera all set up. But like I mentioned, we're gonna set up OBS, the whole thing, so I'm gonna keep it basic, otherwise this video is gonna be 4 to 5 minutes. So of course we're gonna boot up OBS, the software that we're gonna use, to stream.restream.io. all right, so on the very left, I made an extra scene, so this is just a blank one, so we can start from scratch. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're going to load in a stream overlay. That's just gonna, you know, make it look a little bit better. So we're gonna right click in the sources menu and we're gonna go and add in an image. So we're gonna click on there and we're gonna call this stream layout, like that. Then we're gonna, of course, change the image and choose the image that we have made for it. Okay, so now that we loaded that in, we're gonna shrink this full screen, of course, because we want this to fill the entire screen. Then we're gonna also load in a face cam. So we're gonna click on add once more. I'm going to click on video capture device. I'm just gonna call this face cam or webcam, how you wanna call it. Then we're gonna choose what kind of camera we're gonna use, which is, of course, my webcam, the Logitech C925E. So we're gonna click on okay. So there we have, of course, our camera, but the resolution is not what we want. So we're gonna double click on it and we're gonna go scroll down until we see a resolution. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick the resolution / FPS type 2 custom. So I can type in 1, which is going to bring us to 1920x1080, completely full screen. So we're gonna also shrink this guy down, you know, so we can see a lot more gameplay instead of just me full screen. Now you can also chrome out the background. So then what we're gonna do is we're gonna right click on the face cam and we're gonna hit filters. Then we're gonna hit this plus icon at the bottom and we're gonna pick the chroma key. Now of course we can just call this chroma key because that's the name. We don't need to change that or to fill anything in. As you can see right now, OBS is already taking on the background, but it could use a little tweaking because as you can see right here, we have quite a little bit of pixelation going on. So you just want to mess with the similarity until that is actually getting worse or better. Let's see, I think this one is a little too much. So I think that one looks pretty accurate. I know if I, you know, make this one a little bit bigger and if I take out these red lines. Right here, there's a little bit more noise and we can also fix that by shrinking down the resolution. So we still keep, you know, this entire box, but we can cut, you know, certain edges off. So how you want to do that? How you want to do that is you want to hold Alt and Control at the same time. And then this green line appears and you can basically, if you pay attention to these pixels, you can just crop that out and you will still have the same resolution and people won't even notice it. And of course, you can also turn up your webcam just a little bit like that, so you're completely full screen and you can just drag this one, for example, in the bottom right corner. And that is how you can add in your face cam into OBS. Okay, so now that we have multiple aspects into the program itself, we have our face cam in the bottom right corner, we have our stream layout itself. Of course, when somebody donates or follows or becomes a member, I mean like a subscriber on Twitch, a member on YouTube, you know, follows on Twitch, everything you can imagine when it comes to, you know, things that are worth alerting, you need to go to streamlabs.com and you can basically configure all the settings. So if you go over to that website for a second, so right here we are on streamlabs.com. And of course, if you don't know how to set up all these settings, you can check out this card right here where I show you guys how to set up Streamlabs and everything. But it basically comes down that, of course, right here we have all kinds of menus and you can just choose to upload a logo or like donations, for example. You can choose, for example, this dancing guy. You can also, you know, you can load in your own custom music. You can use music from the website itself. So we have this guy from Fresh Prince dancing noticing when somebody is donating, when somebody subscribes. I don't have that set up yet because, of course, a lot of people are subscribing during the live stream, so it's just gonna be really, really annoying, you know, to see constantly, you know, all these pop-ups coming up. But for example, like donating, super chats as well, we have this one set up with just a simple sound effect. You can just upload that, configure that. It only takes like 10 minutes per alert. And then what you want to do is you want to take your widget URL and you want to copy that. Now we're gonna go back to our OBS, and then you want to right click, you want to hit add, and you want to insert a browser. Now, of course, we're gonna just type in alerts, and the cool thing is that you don't need a separate source for donations, you know, super chats, merchandise, subscribers. You don't need to set up 5 or 6 of these separate sources. That's just all gonna be contained in just one URL. Really, really handy. So you can just create one source, call that alerts. All the categories are falling under that, and you just want to basically fill in that URL that we just got from the website. I'm gonna blur it out, and then we're gonna hit OK. It becomes transparent. You can just right click on this source, and of course you can click on center to screen, so it is actually perfectly aligned in the screen. And then anytime when somebody donates, likes, you know, follows, or becomes a member, or buys merch, or basically anything that you have set up an alert for will pop up on your screen. And of course, the last thing and the most important thing to get rid of this black screen, you just want to fill in, for example, a gameplay. So if we're gonna right click, we're gonna go to the game capture, display capture, or window capture, or monitor capture. It all depends on what game you're running and then, like, what FPS. So I wouldn't really, you know, go for a default game capture, like, oh, that's the one you need to go for, because every computer reacts differently to, you know, a certain source, because it can be that, for example, GTA 5 can lag a lot in game capture, but it will actually run flawless, for example, in monitor capture. So it really depends on the game and what you're doing. I would choose your capture device, but I'm just gonna, for example, click on game capture. You can just call this the game itself, and then there will be a list where you can pick your game that you're streaming. And that's basically how it's done, guys. This is how you set up OBS with the alerts, a face cam, the gameplay, a stream layout before you go live on Restream, because of course nowadays it's 2020, you want to look as professional as possible, and that's how to do it. Now you can go live. If you press start streaming on the very right, you will go live on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch at the same time. So that is basically how simple it is.
So guys, that's it for this video. Now you guys know the best settings and how to stream with Restream.io on multiple platforms such as Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch simultaneously. I want to thank Restream.io for sponsoring this video. Thanks a lot for the continued support, guys, and I'll see you guys obviously in the next video.